world, Anissa Mexen, dressed in black and gold, Phetjeeja in the white. Sneaky little uppercut landed by Mexen there as she circled off to land the head kick.
Look for that powerful jab of Mexen. She uses it to boost a frame and an intercepting weapon as her opponents charge forward, trying to find the distance on her. Mexen so good at using her footwork to set up the kicks and the combinations. Her outbreak, her work rate, her output is second to none.
Yeah, Mexen here establishing a great rhythm right off the bat, and you know she can keep this pace for five rounds. So it's gonna be up to Phetjeeja to figure out which weapon she wants to go with and how she wants to fight this fight. She shouldn't try to fight Mexen's fight.
Right hand there from Phetjeeja.
There's the body kick, connects to the midsection of Anissa Mexen. Mexican putting out the jab. She runs into the push kick of Phetjeeja.
Nice angle work there from Phetjeeja. Trying to get away from that jab of Anissa Mexen.
One thing that Phetjeeja does so well is attack the body. That left hook and that right hook downstairs. And if she can find a home for those shots, she could shut the punching down, the punching and down of Mexen, and really control the volume a little bit.
Phetjeeja checking the kicks there of Anissa Mexen. Mexen strings a lot of combinations off the left kick. Look at the defense, the head movement there from Phetjeeja.
It's like trying to stop a waterfall with a bucket. The volume of Anissa Mexen just keeps coming. It is so difficult to slow this young lady down. She is so fast. She is so well conditioned. She can put a pace on you for five rounds over 15 minutes. That is just so hard to deal with. But Phetjeeja is working her way in closer, looking to land the body kicks and use hand combinations.
That was a beautiful exchange there, Phetjeeja, with the right hand and the right kick off the break. Started to find her rhythm a little bit, Phetjeeja.
Every boxing coach is going to tell you, especially when you start fighting, it's really easy to just throw one shot, one power shot, and not make combinations. Mexen just does such a beautiful job of four punches, five punches, six punches. If one doesn't find home, she reams over the top, the guard of her opponent, and finds that opening.
Phetjeeja's doing a good job of standing her ground right in the face of Anissa Mexen, not giving her that backward look that she usually gets from opponents by backing them up with that pressure. She is staying right in there and throwing her combinations. Unthinkable, and stop the oncoming sensation that is Anissa Mexen.
Mexen and Phetjeeja represent the highest levels in the world. When it comes to striking here, one championship, a 95% win rate. Anissa Mexen, a 97% win rate for Phetjeeja, and a beautiful combination there from Mexen.
Phetjeeja there with some clean head movement and counters as well. It's a lot of back and forth here.
Oh, nice right hand from Phetjeeja, rocks the head back of Anissa Mexen.
Mexen is so good at all the different ranges. It doesn't matter if he's in tight or at range, she's so smooth in every single area. The footwork always puts her into proper positioning to fire off. Phetjeeja needs to come forward as she marches into the clinch, throws the elbow. Referee says no clinch are allowed. Phetjeeja.
Anissa Mexen so good at establishing her dominance inside the ring, from the stare down to push it off every time they get into the clinch. Anissa Mexen never allows you to get an upper hand at any given moment, but that was a nice left hand there from Phetjeeja.
Yeah, both fighters trading lefts there. Mexen snapping the left through, and Phetjeeja showing how tough she is, eating the shot and still coming forward.
Good defense from the kicking game of Anissa Mexen. Phetjeeja is able to avoid some of those big kicks. Good footwork, continues on the front foot, lands the body kick as Mexen circles off.
This is what Phetjeeja needs. Use the teeth, use the head movement to disrupt that rhythm of Anissa Mexen, and then land with the single shot. She's not as active as Anissa Mexen, but nice right hand from Phetjeeja. Has a wobble.
Yeah, the looping shot, almost landing behind the ear there and making her lose her balance.
Stuck in a high kick, too, at the end of the hand combination. Phetjeeja goes knee to the body as Mexican continues to work below the chin with the hands. That combination right there, that hook to the body, hook to the head to set up that right hand is one of Phetjeeja's favorites.
A beautiful body kick from Mexican.
I like what I'm seeing here from Phetjeeeja. As the fight wears on, she's getting more and more comfortable, and she's doing that work to the body, which is gonna pay dividends in the fourth and fifth round.
She's 12 years younger, but she's got a lot of experience in that young age, and we're starting to see Phetjeeeja really start to develop here and land some clean shots on the veteran Mexican. One championship, Phetjeeja, Anissa Mexican represent the very best in female striking as Phetjeeja continues to push forward. But Mexican starting to turn things up here in the third round. Mexican still very light on his feet as she attacks up the middle. Phetjeeja pushes forward, looking to land the big right hand.
Contrast between power and volume. Power in the way of Phetjeeja, the queen. Volume in the way of a seven-time Muay Thai kickboxing world champion, Anissa Mexican, looking to earn the only belt she has yet to win, the one world title.
Phetjeeja's doing a good job of shutting down the footwork of Anissa Mexican. She's always cutting the angle, trying to position herself right in front so she can tee off and do this play.
She's found a home for the right hand. It's continuously landing. Mexican would be well served here to use her front kick a little bit, keep that range and stick that jab, because Phetjeeja has really figured out where and how to get that right hand to that jaw.
Mexican has a beautiful kicking game, trained for years in Sabah. We'd like to see more of that, but the footwork of Phetjeeja just keeping the pressure on, staying inside that boxing range. Great utilization of footwork to position herself right into that her range. And then avoid the kicks just like that, parrying. Getting out of the way of the oncoming kicks from Mexican.
Phetjeeja, a career that started at just 6 years old, culminating now into this moment. An opportunity to win the one Atomweight kickboxing world title against a legend, a pound-for-pound great in Anissa Mexican. Oh, nice knee to the body there from Phetjeeja.
Well, not only is Phetjeeja, you know, doing a great job of just ducking her head down a little bit, stepping in with the right hand, finding, yep, but there it is again, a place for it to land. But you can tell she's getting more comfortable. You know, this is a little bit new for her, so she's doing a great job of adapting. And I can only imagine that as the rounds go on, she's just gonna get stronger and stronger.
Yeah, the adaptation is key. She's gotta stop firing off inside the clinch. She's clinching up and then she's firing knees. Ricky Sula has given her warnings on multiple occasions for those knees. So she has to adapt to the kickboxing rule set and abandon that clinch.
I think the warnings for ducking on the head, Mitch, I think the head is kind of hitting Mexican in the clinch. That was what the warning was for, but Phetjeeja now, I think the cleaner of the two, again, landing the more significant shots. Nice little off-balancing there for Phetjeeja.
That's just mental warfare, you know. It's frustrating to be down, looking up at your opponent, having to stand up. It just gets in your head. Mexican is trying to make some adjustments here, fight a little bit longer.
Things, except one championship gold. So much on the line in the penultimate round in the fourth of this world title tilt.
Beautiful body work there from Phetjeeja. Parries that jab, ties up there. Showing fantastic head movement is Phetjeeja. A nice lefty to the body there. Going to work is Phetjeeja at the championship rounds.
Mexican was looking like she wanted to get busy with the jab there early on. She needs to keep that long range though. Phetjeeeja beautifully going to the body, pulling the hands down, and it prevents Mexican from being able to really let the combos unleash.
Ricky Sewell warning again for attacking inside the clinch.
That time there was Mexican that threw the knee off the break. Sharp right hand, then landing. Anissa Mexen, but a response there from Phetjeeja, clubbing right hand.
Phetjeeja enters in with the knee, caught with the left hand on the entry from Mexen. Mexen putting out the jab.
Phetjeeja puts the pressure on. It forces Mexen to throw, but then she just is out of range and she goes back in. There's some really great timing things happening here with Phetjeeeja. Very high level.
With an unbelievable 212 fights, Phetjeeja has never been five rounds. This is the first time she's being pushed into this type of duration. And she's still looking really good and fast and light on her feet.
Looking very conditioned. Phetjeeja, nice right to the body, but a beautiful left hook by Anissa Mexen. Working on the outside, using the lateral movement. Counter, low kick there for Phetjeeja.
Mixing, swinging and missing a few times there. Phetjeeja following up with the counters.
Again, it is Phetjeeja landing the better shots in the exchanges. A little bit of damage now in the face of Anissa Mexen, but Mexen still very active, right on the toes. Snipe it from the long distance, two kicks there. Anissa Mexen, another right hand lands for Phetjeeja.
Phetjeeja's beautiful head movement is positioning herself really well as Mexen takes one on the arm and fires off with the right hand.
Phetjeeja does a great job of, you know, even if she eats a strike, she still commits to her entry and follows up with that right hand. There it is again, beautiful technique.
The fourth
ultra important round that could determine the interim one Atomweight Kickboxing World Champion. An incredible 206 wins, a 97% win rate for Phetjeeja, and a 95%, 103 wins for Anissa Mexen.
Mexen using the check hook there to try and change the angle, doing it successfully, but not really having a follow-up. With Phetjeeja catching the kick, blocking the kick, and returning.
Ryan, what do you think of this forward pressure from Phetjeeja? Always in the face of Mexen. How is that going to weigh in the judges' minds?
Oh, it looks great. This is exactly what she needs to do. But more importantly, it has shut down the barrages for Mexen. So it's good for the judges to see the pressure, and it's good for her because she's taking away all that room.
Mexen continues to work off the jab. Wow. Beautiful head movement as Mexen swings for the hook and Phetjeeja vanishes and disappears to the other side.
Goes to the knee, to the body as well. Phetjeeja finding the swagger in the final round.
Yeah, all the experience that Phetjeeja has is really coming out here in the late stages of this fight. She's attacking, then when she knows the counter is coming back, she's moving her head or using a little backstep. She's not getting completely out of range, though. She still can come back in, and she does such a great job of dropping her head slightly and driving that right hand through.
Good head movement, the roll, the bob, and the weave from Phetjeeja on display as they tie up yet again.
The volume, the output of Anissa Mexen has been high, but it has not found its mark very often. It is this defense, the head movement, the parrying, and the tying up of Phetjeeja working so well.
She does such a good job of eating the space up and then carefully choosing her shots. Those small hooks over the top, a body shot, pushing off, a middle kick.
Phetjeeja, the first time she's going five rounds in her 212 fight career. An astonishing 206 wins for this 22-year-old sensation. Can she do the unthinkable and beat Anissa Mexen at her own game? Somebody who came into One Friday Fights with explosive punching power is really showcasing high-level intellect as these two trade shots at the 10-second clapper.
Jim Fernandez in the red gloves, Phetjeeja in the blue. Boy, Muay Thai division. Seven-leg kick from Phetjeeja.
I like the way Phetjeeja utilizes her push kick. And she starts to set everything off.
Laura's
right hand. Laura's backed up.
She's taking heavy shots, heavy artillery from Phetjeeja.
Phetjeeja's got blood in the water.
And stepping one in the end of Olivier Pettis.
Corner of Fernandez, but wow, Phetjeeja getting it done again.
She has definitely made herself known here in one champion.
First hand, look at this first punch.
Goes inside, catches her right on the temple. The eyes cross. Fernandez goes back into the corner. Phetjeeja was patient, goes to the body, starts letting go. And then referee Olivier Cost, as soon as she gave her back, as soon as she turned away, that is a sign of I do not want to fight anymore. And referee Olivier Cost jumps in there and saves her.
Doesn't want to get backed up. The queen has very intense pressure. She closes the distance really fast, utilizing those fakes, those push kicks. Has a brilliant Muay Mat style, mixes in the leg shots really well, Rich.
Yeah, Celeste can't allow Phetjeeja to just pick at her like this. She does have that high guard style, but you were talking earlier about Phetjeeja going downstairs. She uses those body shots to open up the head beautifully, at least if not in this round, in the later rounds, it'll pay dividends.
Celeste needs to establish something early on here. Right now, she's just sitting there defending, giving Phetjeeja target practice.
Phetjeeja walking down Hansen. Hansen, 7.8 significant strikes per minute. There's a left hook, but back comes Phetjeeja.
Yeah, that left hook was good. She needs to go forward, though. Try to put Phetjeeja on the back foot. Because Phetjeeja going forward is just a juggernaut.
Celeste did a good job with that two-piece combination on the inside, though. Timed it really well, counting Phetjeeja.
Body work by the 21-year-old from Thailand in Phetjeeja.
Putting that midsection to the test. Phetjeeja works really well below the chin. There's great angles, left hook to the body. Teeps find the range, and she starts to fake off that teep. Well, you see that little knee raise, and then she'll enter the boxing range and then start teeing off with the hand combinations. Celeste's got to move.
She's got to return. The thing that Phetjeeja's doing is very smart right now. She's intelligently picking her shots. She's not getting greedy with combinations. Keeping it at a 2-3-piece combo, little feint there. Two-piece combo, now she's measuring up and then readjusts and then hits another two-piece combo. Rather than just getting in a trading war, because she doesn't want to do that with Celeste.
Hansen looking to mix it up on the inside. Gets out of the way of a strike from Phetjeeja. Under a minute left here in the first.
Her defense is not bad. She's got this interesting cross block that she uses quite well. Phetjeeja is not really cutting through that guard as often as we expected, but what she is doing is she is mixing up her shots well, right? So just like that body shot. That's where Celeste has got to be concerned, because once those hands start to come down, it's going to open up that chin. Good leg shot landed by Phetjeeja.
Celeste is playing a great defensive game. She just needs to get Phetjeeja more to think about so that she doesn't have to play so defensively the entire time.
Especially with these small gloves, Rich. Dangerous game to play. And she slid out of the way and she landed a beautiful left hook. That's where she needs to be. Every time Phetjeeja comes forward like this, she needs to create those angles and get out the way. Because now Phetjeeja's gonna pour it on.
And down goes
goes Hansen, though, was going to draw. You're watching one championship, home of the world's greatest martial artist, as Phetjeeja looking to back up. So as Hansen, big body shots there.
Good defense, circled off so far, but it's just pick your poison right here with Phetjeeja.
Even though Celeste landed that nice left hook, and she has the ability to counter and land these shots, one or two rounds isn't going to get done for her.
Hansen now trying to get some offense going in the clinch here with some knees, trying to dig to the body, and she just gets thrown down by Phetjeeja.
Wow, ragdoll.
Yeah, I think Celeste might be cut on the top of her head.
I believe there's some blood in up at Phetjeeja with those elbows right through the middle that are lethal.
Yeah, great adjustment for Phetjeeja, especially because she's in that close range. The elbows are going to be there. And Celeste's doing a good job of keeping her eyes on the, the oncoming weapons that are coming her way. And she's defending quite well the headshots. She is getting touched up now with the elbows and those body shots, though, by Phetjeeja.
Yeah, Phetjeeja's doing a good job of throwing those punches, widening the guard just a little bit, and creating that space to come through the center with the elbow like she just did there.
Phetjeeja, 12.2 significant strikes landed per minute, 36.6 per round, the highest strike rate on the one main roster. Look at this work by Phetjeeja.
Yeah, when you're chopping down a tree, you start at the bottom, you pick your shots, you chip away slowly, and the head will fall. And that's exactly what Phetjeeja's doing. Look at this body work. Beautiful hooks to the body by Phetjeeja. Celeste is making this a fight, though, here in Lupini. She won the Road to One Thailand tournament. Picked up a $100,000 contract to compete here, but when you step foot inside this arena, man, you are facing the very best in the world, and that's exactly what Phetjeeja is. But Celeste is making this a fight. Good body shot again, landed by Phetjeeja. Big hook to follow as she pushes forward.
This is that backward movement that I was talking about that Celeste can't do. She's got to get on those angles.
Cost will separate them, but how tough is Celeste Hansen? She is bloody on the top of her head, and she is still in this matchup as we head towards the third round. Already, Phetjeeja starting off digging to the body and then following up with a couple of lead leg kicks.
Phetjeeja has turned up the volume here in the third and final round, trying to get Celeste the best out of here, but Celeste says, I'm still in it. A lot of people count her out in this fight, and she wants to prove everybody wrong, and her going the distance, Rich, might be a moral victory.
I believe that it is a moral victory. I think that we've seen that Phetjeeja in this match right here, the volume between the two of these, the crispness of Phetjeeja's punches, she's just on a different level with her speed, her hand combinations. And so Celeste coming out of this, putting on a performance where she's able to go the distance, is a victory within itself.
And Celeste Hansen not going away easy, guys. There's a head kick that rattled Hansen, another one.
That's what I think Hansen is kind of scared of. She's scared of going forward and initiating shots when Phetjeeja starts to tee off because she might get caught, and that's what happened right there.
This one is over, as on the advice of the ringside physician, Olivia Cost waves it off. That is
absolutely stone cold.
Definitely has a stoic look, but Phetjeeja is known to take those looks and wipe them off your face with those body shots. She's got a beautiful left hook to the body. She's closing the distance with those kicks.
decorated as Paludi is, this is a massive step up. Phetjeeja, one of the best in this division.
Paludi needs to be careful reaching for that leg kick. It's not a good tell to have.
Beautiful combination, slips out, comes back with right hand, left hook, and a low kick to follow.
Paludi needs to get something going to earn some respect. As Phetjeeja is walking her down.
She's trying to get caught on the ropes. Phetjeeja will let the hands fly. We saw it in her last bout, just unloaded with combinations.
Phetjeeja is undefeated in boxing as she catches Paludi with that beautiful left hook. Already touched up the face of Paludi.
To find a way to stop that forward pressure. Phetjeeja, the hands right now, cannot keep her away. Needs to tie out, needs to use the legs a little bit more. Phetjeeja's finding the counter for the jab.
Phetjeeja's doing a beautiful job of utilizing that left hook to get Paludi to circle to her power side. She's walking right into that right side, which is adding a little bit more oomph to those leg kicks.
Every time Paludi looks to throw out that jab, slip and counter. There's a body shot there from Phetjeeja.
Phetjeeja unloading. The elbows finishing. Paludi needs to get moving. Get on that bike, in and out. Throw some combinations. Earn some respect, because right now, Phetjeeja is walking her down. And you can see the damage that's starting to build up on that lead leg. He needs Paludi. That left hook is picture perfect. Doubling up on it, crumbles Anise. Anise smiles down to the river's bomb like, yeah, she got the answer like in the way.
Left hook right on the temple. Phetjeeja comes fly. She gonna look to close the show, bitch.
Phetjeeja trying to get her out of the first. Anise needs to move. 14 seconds. Can Paludi get out of the first?
Finishing sequence, just elbow right into a double left hook. The boxing on full display. Phetjeeja really landed everything she threw tonight. That's the first, the finishing sequence. That one left, right hand, right on the temple of Paludi. The accuracy as well, fluidity run to the body. That one hurt her, the right one, got it done. The queen is definitely back. Phetjeeja earns a first round knockout. Look at the celebration. Waves to the ground.
Phetjeeja!
Phetjeeja with a first round TKO. No doubt this will be a great learning experience for the young Inez Paludi.
That is Phetjeeja.
Looking good so far, circling away from that power side, keeping her with the deep range.
He's also really strong inside that clinch, able to tie up Phetjeeja and nullify any strikes that could be coming her way. Big wide motions though coming from Fani. She's reacting to some of the feints as Phetjeeeja lands a beautifully timed right hand.
That was quick, Mitch, came out of nowhere.
Yeah, this is Phetjeeja's first time in small gloves, so I'm really interested to see how those hands look as she touches Fani again with that right hand.
Beautiful trip as well to end that combination. Phetjeeja showing us why she's so highly regarded. Fani, though, does not look to turn, throwing combinations, trying to keep Phetjeeja away.
Phetjeeja's doing a good job utilizing that push kick, right? She throws the push kick and then she feints and then she looks for the hands. So she's getting Hanoopi to think about downstairs and then upstairs as well with the hand combinations.
What I like how, I like how she's tying up Phetjeeja. Every time Phetjeeja's looking to step in, Fani's looking to wrap the hands. Stop that forward pressure.
Very experienced in these small gloves. She knows exactly what she needs to do with the small gloves. She's a bare knuckle fighting champion. She's very used to being either gloved up or not gloved at all. And she's moving well, utilizing that circular movement to the weak side, but it's right there. It's those little exchanges where Phetjeeja is so dangerous. Oh, dig into the body. Phetjeeja immediately tries to cut off that angle. Smart by Hanoopi, tie her up, and slow down that onslaught that was coming from Phetjeeja.
Well, she has to, because she ate that huge left hook and had her wobble.
Phetjeeja in those hands, again with the left hook. As Hanoopi dumps Phetjeeja to the ground. Yeah, very important for Hanoopi to keep her guard nice and high. Slap box with Hanoopi. Oh, Phetjeeja going with the question mark kick. Goes up top, shimmy chin. Oh, nice. That hook. That hook, Gianni. That hook keeps touching Hanoopi.
Hanoopi now standing her ground, deciding to trade with Phetjeeja. Sometimes you can't keep an opponent off you. You have to gain her respect. That's a nice sweep by Phetjeeja.
Phetjeeja!